Hi dear students, welcome back to another session of human resource management. We reached the session of 57 where I am going to discuss on the topic types of performance appraisal. Dear students, in the previous session we discussed many issues which are relating to the methods of performance appraisal, traditional methods of performance appraisal, and also the role and importance of performance appraisal. In detail, elaborately we discussed the issue that what it is actually. Now moving on to the wonderful aspect, that is to discuss by having a more example, that is types of performance appraisal. Let's move on to my first slide, where many organizations adopt the policy of regular appraisal of the performance of their employees. This helps the management in many ways. Regular performance appraisal reports are tabled before the bosses, who inter initiates required action. This is done in informal way of discussion, dialogue or communication or constant supervision of his performance. In no time fixed for such appraisal, particularly from that organization to evaluate performance appraisal of the employee. So this is the introductory part. Let's moving on to the next. In my second slide, I have incorporated four important or four categories of performance appraisal, or you may call it as four types of performance appraisal. Number one is formal appraisal, number two is informal appraisal, number three is objective appraisal, and then last one is subjective performance appraisal. Let's discuss all the four categories, that how it is derived while we are going to evaluate the performance appraisal, and what process that these types of performance appraisal will take place in the organization. Let us discuss one by one. Number one is formal appraisal. Many organizations adopt the policy of regular appraisal of the performance of their employees. This helps the management in many ways. Regular performance appraisal reports are tabled before the bosses, who inter initiates required action. A permanent and common procedure is adopted for all the employees, and their evaluation is made on predetermined standards. Such an appraisal is made at regular intervals, maybe quarterly, half yearly or yearly, and so on. A permanent record of such appraisal is maintained. This formal appraisal helps the administration in assessing the development. If there is no improvement, the employee is taken to task, and if there is a significant improvement, rather development, the employee is rewarded. Such a policy motivates the employees. Thus, a regular and standardized appraisal is known as formal performance appraisal. So this is what the first type of formal appraisal, where the things could be which will always cope up to the administrative issues, where the ministerial staffs and then the court staffs, and also in somehow the issues relating to the government and then the private sector, are assessing these types of appraisal for the purpose of the development and then growth of that organization, particularly if they are doing the administration work. And there is also the improvement of the employee has been taken place. If formal appraisal has to be evolved, when the improvement and then significant of that development of the employee will be rewarded accordingly. Such a policy motivates the employee, and also such a policy will not only motivate the employees, but also which will reward the that employee, and that employee will taken into that place, that he is going to get more monetary benefits. A regular and then standardized appraisal is what actually we are calling the performance appraisal, which is to be maintained permanent record as per the point that I made in the previous session. Quarterly they may collect, half yearly, or thrice in a year, or years once they will collect the performance appraisal. There is a procedure, common procedure, that can be adopted permanently where the employee have to be evaluated, particularly under predetermined standards. So many organizations adopt the policies which will relate to the performance appraisal of their employees, where the management in many ways are going to help. Regular performance appraisal reports are tabled before of the CEO of that company, or MD of that company, or altogether including of that human resource manager in particular, to make an action of that performance appraisal of that employee. These issues that we will only discuss under formal appraisal, which is the one of the type of performance appraisal. Let's move on to the second types of performance appraisal, is all about informal appraisal. On the contrary to the formal appraisal, this is done at the any moment of time by the immediate supervisor. If he feels it necessary, there is no standardized procedure for this. The supervisor may assess the performance of any subordinate if he feels necessarily. Such appraisal is aimed at assessing the consistency of a particular employee in his performance. Well, we are going to make it an informal appraisal. This is done informal way of discussion, dialogue, or communication, or constant supervision of his performance. There is no time fixed for such appraisal. The supervisor gets the feedback from the employees and thus knows whether he has followed the instructions or whether he could understand the way to perform a job, particularly the performance appraisal are concerned. Informal appraisal will always up to the enterprise as to which type of appraisal is adopted, but then both are supplementary to each other. As such, many enterprises adopt both the types of formal appraisal, enables the management to get regular information, and also informal appraisal gets them feedback. This feedback helps the management to formulate the policies for human atmosphere development. See, the development and then growth of that organization will always formulate the management, which will took the little bit of feedbacks, where the regular information and then the informal appraisal will be enables us the management to have such types of formal appraisal to be considered, comparing with the informal appraisal. The enterprise which will the types of appraisal where it will be adopted, it is left to them according to the discussion made out by the CEO and then the MD, and also from the human resource manager. Supplementary to that aspect, they will decide that what type of the informal way of discussion, dialogue, or communication, or you may call it as constant supervision performance, has to be done under that organization. There is no such time fixed for this appraisal because it is informal appraisal. The supervisor, or who is the head of that organization, will always getting the feedback from that employee, which will always discuss the whether he's followed the instruction or not. That can only be identified by the recruiter or the human resource manager to understand the way to perform a job. Obviously, as I said, the supervisor may assess the performance of any subordinate if he feels necessary, and then the standardized procedure of this such appraisal is aimed at assessing the consistency of a particular employee in his performance. As far as the moment of time by immediate supervisor is feels to necessary, the direct directly the human resource manager will go with informal appraisal to evaluate the employee. This is also one of the best type of performance appraisal, dear students. Please follow. This is also how informal appraisal will works out in the organization to make an evaluation, particularly regarding to the performance appraisal. Number three is objective appraisal. Objective appraisal is also one of the type of performance appraisal where evaluation of performance with a specific object can be termed as objective performance appraisal. Such an appraisal is aimed at assessing the performance of the workers against some specific standard. Such standards are based on job analysis and evaluation. Thus, objective appraisal assesses the performance on specific job. It does not include any other aspect in which is otherwise performance is not considered. Such an appraisal removes misconceptions regarding the performance on the specific job. Objective performance evaluation apparently looks to be the best as far as workers' performance on the particular job is concerned. But it is difficult to measure management potential. See, the if objective appraisal is decided to be undertaken preliminary rights from the understanding the job, then analyzing it and afterwarding fixing the measurement or assessment standard are required to be done. If such evaluation is required for a number of employees, it may be consumed more time and naturally more expenditure, which is the nutshell objective performance appraisal is a best for the job, but it is expensive. So this is what the almost all the private and then public sector branches or the department are using this appraisal of objective, because objectivity is there, then the performance will be appears in a good manner. There is no question of partiality and then bifurcation as done. So the expensive of this performance of that objective appraisal will be costlier, rather than considering the costlier one, which is always consume more time, and then naturally it will take more time for evaluation of that employee's performance appraisal. See, the thing is that the objective performance evaluation apparently looks to the best as far as worker performance on particular job is concerned, but it is a difficult measure management potentially, because where the preliminary is right from the understanding the job, then analyzing the afterwards fixing the measurement or assessment standards are to be required as far as objective performance are concerned. See, this is the evaluation performance in regarding to the specific object by framing the many questions to the employee. The objective performance are to be evaluated to the employee. So, and also if there is a mutual coordination to the between employer and then employee, should always look upon the assessing the performance of the workers against some specific standard, such as on the policies and also for the evaluation. Dear students, this is what the third type of the number three type of performance appraisal, that is objective appraisal. Fourth one is a subjective performance appraisal, which again it is the opposite to the objective appraisal, where informal appraisal is opposite to the formal appraisal. Subjective performance appraisal is on the contrary to the objective evaluation. Subjective evaluation is meant for overall evaluation of the worker performance. Thus, it gives more information to the management. Such evaluation is aimed at assessing the general performance of the employees. The performance is assessed as well as evaluated against general standards and not specific standards. Same standards are made applicable for evaluation of all the workers in the same category. There may be some upgradation and or downgradation for different categories. Subjective appraisal equips the management on various matters of employees' performance, their overall drawbacks, extra potential in some employees, which in turn help the management to decide promotions, placement, bonus and rewards of etc. So this is what the subjective one, which is always opposite to objective appraisal. The thing is, when you are going to evaluate the subject evaluation, in regard particularly meant to the overall evaluation of the worker performance, it gives more information to the management rather than getting the objective appraisal. Or you may depending upon objective appraisal, I don't think so that we are going to get full information comparing with the subjective performance appraisal. Such evaluation is aimed at assessing the general performance of the employees. The performance is assessed as well as the evaluate against the general standard of that employee, which will always specifically maintained by the organization. There are many standards which is not applicable relating to the evaluation of that worker, because that worker or that employee may be working under such circumstances which is not having get the job satisfaction as well. So there may be some upgradation or downgradation are there in the different categories. This is the subjective appraisal which will equips the management on various matters of the employee performance are concerned. So with this, dear students, I will stop here. This is what all the four types of performance appraisal. I don't want to recall in detail because this is how things could be. I have prepared a study material. I will also upload this study material with MCQ and all these PPTs and all these videos to the LMS, that is learning management system. Already we provided your user ID and then password to you students that follow this video by getting under LMS. So there are four types, that is formal appraisal, informal appraisal, which is contradictory to formal appraisal. Number three is objective appraisal, and then number fourth one is subjective performance appraisal, which is always contradictory to the objective appraisal. So all these four types of performance appraisal are categorized by many thinker, those who are worked particularly relating to the human resource management. So dear students, I will stop here in the last slide, obviously, which will carry the source of reference. Dear students, please follow this source of reference for your for the purpose of to get more knowledge, but at the same time to get more specific issues relating to the performance appraisal. In regarding to the performance appraisal, George Bolander and then Scott Snell, they mentioned in detail in their book Human Resource Management, where it is SMKJ and Learning Private Limited published. It is in Jannat Nagar, New Delhi. This is a wonderful book, where all the issues, content, concepts relating to the performance appraisal covered by these two fellows. So with this, students, I will stop here. I will come up with a new session and the new topic with the session of 58. So as of now, I will conclude the session that I discussed in detail of types of performance appraisal. With this, bye bye. Thank you very much.